In this video, we will discuss about how to generate the ad tags for the ad unit that we created in the Ad Manager account. Now I have logged in, or I am using the website called as dfpgpt.appspot.com. Now this website gives us an easy way to generate the ad tags for multiple ad units at once. So I recommend using this because this is an easy way for generating the ad tags. Here the tag type should be GPT, network code, network ID. Every DFP has a network ID. So just for teaching purposes, I'm inputting any random DFP network ID. We will discuss about the custom targeting in our next topic, as custom targeting is also a way of segmenting your inventory. So we will cover this in the later parts of the videos. However, so just for the sake of understanding, I am inputting any value as a equal to 1. Let's suppose I'm creating an ad unit for the travel 1, 2, 3, 4. I want 300 cross 250 ad to serve on this ad unit. So here it is. So I can generate the tags now. It is simple as that. Now, if you notice, the single request architecture is enabled by default. Now, single request architecture, what it does, like let's suppose that I have 4 ad units on my page. Now, without single request architecture, each ad unit will make a separate call to the ad manager server. Now, with single request architecture, all the 4 ad units or all the 4 ad slots that are on my page will be clubbed and a single call will be made to the Google Ad Manager server. Now, doing this will reduce the page load time or will reduce the ad fetch time on your page. So this is highly recommended if you have multiple ad slots on your page. Now I can generate the tags. Now if you see, there are two parts of the GPT code. GPT is nothing but the Google Publisher tags, head part and the body part. Now let's discuss this, what exactly do they mean. Now we have something called as defined slot here. You can see an ad space is created. Now this ad space is created. How this is created? Because I've just generated the tag and deployed it in the source code of the page. If you want to see, you can like click on the here. This is an ad space that has been created. So this defined slot. Now this defined slot is very necessary. Now this, what is the function of this defined slot? This defined slot is, it makes a call to the ad server. It is responsible for making an ad call or making an ad request to the ad manager. Now this 1234 here is the network ID or the DFP network ID. Travel 1234 is the ad unit name. It is the parent ad unit name. This is the network ID. This is the parent ad unit name. This is the size I have requested. And this is the ad slot name. Ad slot name, it can be anything as long as it is unique to your web page. It can be anything. This is an auto-generated one, but it can be anything. This is the div ID. We call it as a div ID. And this is a function for single request architecture, enable single request. That means if I have multiple slots on my web page, I can club all these slots and make the GPT code send a single request to the ad manager or the Google DFP network. Now here, Google tag.pubads.setTargeting A1. So this is my key value. I can identify it by looking at the code that this is my key value. Now let's come to the body part and discuss what exactly this is. Now let's look at this code. Now this is a very important code. Now this is called as the display call. Now this display call is responsible for making the creative serve in that ad slot. Now this is a random DFP network. This DFP network does not exist, which is why there is no ad serving on this ad slot. I've just created an ad space here. Now, however, if it is a valid DFP network and if you want an ad to be served in the ad space, this display call is responsible for making the creative render in this ad slot, making the creative fit in this ad slot, which is why this display call is there here. And if you notice, this ID is the same. This ID and this ID is the same. If the defined slot div ID and the display slot div ID do not match, there will be no ad serving into the ad space. So it is very necessary to keep in mind that this div ID, display defined slot div ID, and the display slot div ID should exactly match without any error for the ad to render in the ad space which we have just now created. Let's go back again and see how to generate the tags for multiple ad units on the page. I'm giving it as 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm enabling the single request architecture. I'm inputting a equal to 1 as my key value, targeting here. So let's create an ad unit for the travel one. I want 300 x 250 size to serve on this ad slot. I'm taking the same ad unit here. As I have told you previously that the ad unit is not limited by its size. You can have the same ad unit and create 3 ad spaces on your network, I mean on your web page, and serve the ads there. So I can have one more ad unit. I can keep the ad unit name as same, and on this ad unit, on this ad space, I want to have 728 cross 90 ad. Let's create one more, and I will keep the ad unit name as same, and on this I want 300 cross 600 ad to be served. So let's generate the tag. You can see this is the ad slot name. See, the ad unit is same, but ad unit across all the 3 ad slot is same, but the sizes are different. So which is why in our previous section of creating an ad unit, I left the ad unit sizes field as blank. However, you can go there and input any sizes that you want, but I do not do so because while generating the tag, I can give the ad unit size there. So a single ad unit can have multiple sizes. This is what I was trying to explain. So now this defined slot. So the number of defined slot, now there are 3 defined slots here. So the number of defined slot indicates that there will be 3 slots on your pages. If suppose there are 4 defined slots, that means there will be 4 spaces on your web pages. Similarly, if there are 4, if this, in this example there are 3 defined slots, that means there will be 3 display calls here. There will be 3 display functions here, and each DYD should match with the corresponding display function. For this, it should match with my first display function. For this DYD of this defined slot of the second ad unit, it should match with the second display function. Similarly, the third DYD of the third ad unit of this, the defined slot of the ad unit should match with the third display function. If there is any mismatch between these, your ad will not be rendered. A request will be made because there is a defined slot, but your ad will not be rendered because the display function is responsible for rendering the creative, for making the creative to fit in your ad space. So this was about the ad unit generation for multiple ad units at once. So this is highly recommended. Even Google Ad Manager also has a way to generate a tag. However, you will be able to generate the tag only for the one ad unit. You may not do so for multiple ad unit at once. So this is the best way, an easy way. It can save a lot of your time. Next, now we have enabled single request architecture also. Now what does this do? Without this, each defined slot will make a different call, individual call to the ad server. Now with this, all the 3 ad unit or the ad slots will be clubbed together and a single call will be made to the Google ad server. So by doing this, your ad fetch time or your ad, the page would load faster. So these are the advantages of using the single request architecture. And I strongly advise that you use single request architecture whenever you want to place the ad units on the source code of your pages. Thank you so much. That was it from all of us at eGita.com.